Hi dear 10th class students, how are you all? I'm fine today. I hope you are also fine. So today I'm coming with a wonderful topic. Today, before coming to our topic, I would like to explain myself. You know me very well. I am Saidulu Karlapudi, English teacher working at JPSS Ravinathala Bonakal Mandal, Khamman district. So I'm a psychologist as well as English teacher. I have my contact number 9177668428. If you have any doubts, you may contact me for more details in English and some other topics, especially psychological topics. Now let us see our lesson and also our topic. What is our topic? You can understand what is our topic. Okay, nation and diversity. When coming to our nation is nothing but India. When we come to what is a nation's strength is youth, having spirituality, morality, and all these things are our nation's strength. But our nation's strength is entirely different from all other nations. Indians are special. Indians are entirely different from all other the world. India is really a diversified nation, because unity in diversity we will see in our India. That is resembling in our picture. Look at this picture. So here it is a gully cricket. You know cricket. How many of you play cricket, my dear students? Raise your hands. Okay, I play cricket. Do you know? I play cricket. I bowl, I bat, I also field very well. I am a good bowler, especially left hand bowling. Okay, left hand spin bowler. Okay, forget about this one. Here is a cricket. Who is playing cricket? Saduji is playing, and there is one more Saab. Our Nawab is playing, and I don't know who is in the other end. Who might be in the other end? Just imagine. Okay, maybe some Sikh or some Jain or some Christian or something like that. You can understand this game is resembling our unity. How is our unity? Even though there are so many religious differences, there are so many religions in the world, India is one. India is united. India is a nation. Okay, that nation is Indians. We call ourselves Indians. We don't be called ourselves as Christians or Muslims or and so on, Brahmins or so and so on. But we are very much interested to be called as an Indian. Yes or no? Very good. Now let us have a questionnaire. We are talking about 10th class unit national diversity. First question: what does this picture signify? This picture is signifying, yes, our unity. Our gully cricket, no, it is resembling our unity. Okay, who may be the bowler? Just imagine, we have some recapitulation of my class just before 2 minutes. Come again, who may be the bowler? Maybe a Sikh, the bowler may be Christian. Okay, you are right. Can you expect the fielders? Who are they? Oh, shops are closed due to Sunday or some bandh or something like that. So all the shopkeepers may be fielders. They are playing on the tar road. You see the shade of these people. The shade is nearly, yes, it is in the afternoon, maybe around 12:30, 1 like that. Because you can observe their shades. The bricks shade is there itself. The sadhu's shade is also bent. So that you can pre-assume, you can expect easily that they are playing in the hot sun. Especially when you see their faces, it seems very hot, and it seems very, 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 very hot summer. That's why you may say maybe April, maybe May, or we don't know, maybe June. But really, cricket makes all of us unite. Okay, now forget about that one. Come to the fourth question. How many players are there in cricket? Come on, tell me. Okay, recently the cricket matches were going on. You could see them. So that you can say 11 players. Okay, good. 11 players. Okay. Do you experience the theme reflected in the picture in your real life? You see the picture. Did you play cricket like this anytime? Not bothering about the religion, not bothering about the caste, not bothering about the age. I sometimes play with my children, especially when they are in a 6th class, 7th class, 8th class, 10th class. I make some groups. I call them as a team, and they will select from 6th class one fellow, from 3rd class one more boy, 4th class from one more boy. Sometimes girls also come into participation in the cricket match in my school. It is quite natural. Okay, it is quite natural. I just got experience about this one. What about you? Okay, if not, what may be the possible reason for this? Now, there is a small oral work for you. This is from our textbook, Oral Discourse. Talk on unity in diversity in the spirit of our nation. Okay, this is your homework for our completion of the lesson. Before going into our class, just let us have a glimpse of some pictures of APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, shall we see? Okay, let us see. Here is a picture. Yes, my picture is at his feet, it's no doubt. You look at this man, he is a child. When APJ Abdul Kalam was a child, look at his eyes, look at his face, look at his, wow, his hairstyle. The boy is really very, very, very pleasantable, very happy kid. Here is a man, the same happiness, the same pleasantries, the same hairstyle seems to be here even at the age of 55 or 60, like that, even after becoming the president of India. It is a rare picture, maintaining the same innate goodness, maintaining the same pleasantries, maintaining the same smile on the face when he was unknown child and a well-known president of India, first citizen of India. What a wonderful thing. See, so many people are forgetting their laughing, forgetting their smile. They are just maintaining a portrait smile, maintaining just a fixed smile on the faces. Because to live in this world, because to survive in this world, they are just wearing masks and living. But here is the man without mask. He is just having a wonderful smile on his face. I love this man. Yes or no? Let us see some more pictures. Oh, a family picture. His father, his mother, and his sister, and his brother. What a family picture it is. Yes or no? Okay. Now let us go and see one more picture. A young Kalamji. APJ Abdul Kalamji at an age, at the time of studying. This picture seems to be like studying intermediate or 10th class, like that, no? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. Now let us go and see the president's picture, APJ Abdul Kalam's picture with the children. But he loves children. He loves to talk to children. He loves to encourage the children. He loves to motivate the children towards good. Okay, my dear students, let us see one more picture as a paper boy. Oh, he was a hardworking. You can understand very easily on seeing this picture. Such a hardworking boy he was. Yes or no? Okay, now let us go and see the video of APJ Abdul Kalam. All of you, just have a glimpse.
We should know how to handle, not only how to handle the success, how to handle the failures. Particularly, you are in the management environment. I want the young people to understand how to manage the failure. Because any task you do, you have to come across problem. Problem should not become the captain of the individual or the project chief. The project chief should become the captain of the problems and defeat the problem and succeed. Learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great. History has proven
history has proven that those who dare to imagine the impossible are the ones who break all the human limitations. In every field of human endeavor, whether science, medicine, sports, art or technology, the names of the people who imagined the impossible are engraved in our history. By breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. You take C.V. Raman, you take Newton, you take Einstein, you take Chandrasekhar, by breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. If you want to be discoverers, if you want to be innovators, I am going to give you what type of characteristic you must have. Invention and discoveries have emanated from creative minds that have been constantly working and imagining the outcome. The telephone, he was imagining the outcome in the mind. With imaging and constant effort, all the forces of the universe work for that inspired mind, thereby leading to invention, discoveries.
Sir, I would like to hear from you a few tips for the upcoming generation to succeed in life.
Well, succeeding life, I have already told you.
Yes, sir.
You have to do 4 things, okay? Number 1, great aim.
Great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will continuously acquire knowledge.
Continuously acquire knowledge.
Oh, I will do hard work.
I will do hard work.
I will persevere.
I will persevere.
And succeed.
And succeed.
Okay, that's the mantra.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
You have many accomplishments. You've written books. You've served as president. You're an aerospace engineer. You've been a professor. But you say the title you like best is the title of teacher. Why is that?
You know, I had a teacher when I was a young boy, 10 years boy. Wartime, the Second World War going on. At that time, I used to see in my class, 5th class teacher, in science teacher, he entered the classroom. And we used to see the radiation of knowledge from him. When he enters the classroom, my teacher, I see radiation of purity of life. And my dream has got shaped. What should be my way of life? He is the person, the teacher, gave me the vision of my life when I was a young fellow. Now, a teacher has got a fantastic opportunity to grow minds, to enrich the minds, and give the dreams to the young people, and nurture the dreams with them, and they will become a great human being. Sometime they will become better than you, but better than the teacher. So that opportunity to have.
Okay, dear students, how is the speech of APJ Abdul Kalam? I think you liked it. So his speech is really wonderful, and he loved to be a teacher, not he loved to be a scientist. He is not interested to be a president of India, though he worked all of them, though he was able to manage them, though he was able to wonderfully 100% perform his skills. But here he finally said he wanted to become a teacher. He wanted to continue his life as a teacher because his teachers were with the radius of knowledge. He also gave a mantra. If you want to know the mantra, please watch this video once again and you just record it. You may just by heart it and you may proceed it and follow it to become a wonderful person. Let us know about the book which he wrote, Wings of Fire. What is that? Wings of Fire. Wings of Fire, an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. My dear friends, my dear students, what is a biography? What is an autobiography? Do you know? If you know well, it's okay. If you don't know, don't worry. Biography means the life history of some other person. Autobiography means life history of one's own. If you write your life history, that is called autobiography. If I write my life, that is called my autobiography. If I write your story, that is biography. If you write my story, that is also biography. Okay. Okay, my dear students, now let us see. Former President of India. He was a President of India. It was written by APJ Abdul Kalam and Arun Tiwari. Okay. Dr. Kalam examines his early life, early effort, hardship, fortitude, luck, and chance that eventually led him to lead an Indian space research, nuclear, and missile programs. All these things he mingled up in his book. Kalam started his career after graduating from aerospace engineering at MIT Chennai, India. Oh, he also completed, what did he complete? Master's degree in aeronautical space engineering in MIT Chennai. Okay, at Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, and was assigned to build a warcraft prototype. He also was able to create a prototype model, a role model of warcraft, a model, what we can say, prototype model. So if you want to know what is prototype, just you go and search what is a prototype, what is a flow chart, and what is a diagram, and so on, you will get the details. Later, he moved to ISRO. What is ISRO, you know? ISRO is a space research organization that belongs to India, Indian Space Research Organization, and helped establish the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center and pioneered the first space launch vehicle program. He was the pioneer. He was the beginner of this one to launch the vehicle program. During the 1990s and early 2000, Kalam moved to the DRDO to lead the Indian nuclear weapons program. Oh, India is with the nuclear powers now. That is, all credit should be to our APJ Abdul Kalam only. When he was working in DRDO, he was the, he was the programmer, he was the head programmer to lead this thermonuclear weapons. With the particular success in thermonuclear weapons development, Kalam knitting, just a minute, just I will drag my photo up so that it can be very clear. Okay, stop here, okay. With a particular success in a thermonuclear weapons development culminating in the operation Smiling Buddha and an ICBM Agni missile. Look at this one, Agni missile, and all these things were by his hands. Kalam died on 27th July 2015 during a speech at Indian Institute of Management in Shillong, Meghalaya. What a lucky person he is. He is a famous, he is a well known, his desire was to be a teacher, and he died as a teacher while he was teaching. His death is resembling that he is a great person, that he is a wonderful person, and also his death is showing a great thing that he desired. Now let us go and see some other things from our unit. Okay, the autobiography first published. Autobiography was first published in English, has so far been translated and published into 13 languages, including Hindi, English, Bangla, Bengali, Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayalam, Odia, Marathi, and Gujarati. Outside of the major Indian languages, Wings of Fire was translated into Chinese. So there is a name in Chinese, Hu Yi by Ji Peng. What is the name? Huyi. And into French by various translators. It was translated into worldwide languages now. Okay. My dear friends, let us go and see from our textbook what is there. Look at this one. The book is, it is about APJ Abdul Kalam, about the author. Dr. Awul Pakir Jainul Abdin Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 at Rameswaram in Tamil Nadu. Okay, his birth area, his birth details are given. He was responsible for evaluation of ISRO's launch vehicle program, particularly the PSLV configuration, and for the development of operationalization of AGNI and Prithvi missiles and for building indigenous capability in a critical technologies through networking of multiple institutions. In his literary pursuit, four of Dr. Kalam's books, Wings of Fire, India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium, My Journey, and Ignited Minds, Unleashing the Power Within India, have become household names in India and among the Indian nationals abroad. So all his four books, really wonderful books. I read really this one, Ignited Minds, Unleashing the Power Within India, which is really a marvelous book. We cannot say with the words, just only we have to read, then only we will just unleash the power within us. We have a lot of power. Our power is wonderful. That is what mentioned in this book. Dr. Kalam received honorary doctorates from 30 universities and institutions. You see, now getting a doctorate, being called by the university or some people as a doctorate is a question mark. But this man got 30 universities doctorates. He was awarded the coveted civilian awards, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, and the highest civilian award, Bharat Ratna. What a wonderful person. Dr. Kalam became the 11th President of India on 25th July 2002. So all these are the landmarks of this man, his character, his simplicity, his hard work, and also his endeavor, and also his superficial, what we can say, hard-working nature. He dedicated his life for this India. That's why he became a role model for everyone. Let us go into our lesson now. So before going to our lesson, let us see these meanings. If you want to write these meanings, please have a screenshot otherwise, so that we will get all these meanings in the forthcoming lesson. Okay, you see all these meanings. I don't want to explain each and every word. Whenever we get the doubt, we could just come back to this slide and see the meanings. Okay, now let us go to next page, that is the beginning of our lesson. You see, read the following extract from Wings of Fire, where the former President of India speaks of his childhood. Okay, my childhood. Whose childhood is this? APJ Abdul Kalam's childhood. What is the difference between childhood, childish? There are so many words related to childhood, childish, children, child. Yes or no? Children is there. Children is a noun. Child is a noun. Childish behavior. Childish is an adjective. Childhood is a noun. Childhood. Okay? My childhood. When I was a child, I was born into a middle class Tamil family in the island town of Rameshwaram in the erstwhile Madras state. Okay? So, Rameshwaram was in the Madras state before. My father, Jainulabdin, his father name was Jainulabdin, had neither much formal education nor much wealth. Now you can easily understand neither nor. Somebody pronounce neither nor. No problem. Pronunciation is not the matter here. Neither nor. Not he nor she. Now you can easily understand Jainulabdin had no formal education, no wealth. Look at this one. No wealth, it is not right. Not much wealth, not much formal education. You can understand formal education is in the sense of going to school and studying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 classes like that. But here, this man doesn't have formal education. So that you can say, he is not illiterate, but he is literate. He knows something, but not all. He did not study up to degree, something like that. And also, he is not very poor. He is not very wealthy also. Wealthy. Healthy is wealth, we say. Okay? Much wealth. Despite these disadvantages, the opposite word of advantages is disadvantages. Despite these disadvantages, he possessed great innate wisdom. Oh, his father was having, possess, have, own. Okay, do you understand? He has a great wisdom. How is the wisdom? Innate wisdom. Where did it come from? From his birth onwards. Everyone is born with the innate goodness. But here, the here is a man, Jainulabdin Kalam, was born with the innate wisdom. What is a wisdom? Wisdom means having the divine knowledge, having what is right, what is wrong knowledge. Knowing what is right and what is wrong is called, I can say very simply, is called wisdom. Wisdom is entirely different from knowledge. Praveen sir, just I pressed on the windows, it came. Okay, wisdom means that is what? Okay, so innate wisdom and a true generosity of spirit. What is generosity? Generosity, kindness, showing mercy, showing sympathy, showing pity, that is called generosity. What a generous person is. Generosity is the word which is the highest word, especially a great word when we talk about kindness. Sita is a kind girl. I show pity. So like that we use this word. Okay? He has a wonderful generosity of spirit. He had an ideal helpmate. Ideal. Ideal means model. Role model. Ideal means role model. Helpmate. Who is the helpmate? His helpmate was none other than his wife. Okay? Life partner. Life mate. Classmate. Like that you see. No, don't say classmate. Okay, forget about that. Helpmate in my mother. What is his mother name? Look at this one. Ashima. What is his name? Ashima. Ashiyamma. Ashiyamma. I do not recall the exact number of people she fed every day. Oh, feed, fed, fed. What is this word? Feed, fed, fed. She feeds every day. She feeds every day. But here it is talking about past tense. So, she fed every day. How many people? Exactly, I can't recall. I don't recall exactly exact number of the people who came to my house. But I am quite certain that far more outsiders ate with us than all the members of our own family put together. Every day, outsiders used to come and eat in their house. So that you can easily understand, this family is such a generous family, maintaining generosity, wonderful generosity. I don't know, this much generosity is missing nowadays. Yes or no? Generous people. So what did she do? She fed every day. How many people? More than the family members. More outsiders than our own family put together. This is what? The greatness. Let us recall some words. Wise, wisdom. Okay, this wisdom is a noun. What does it mean? Innate, the by birth quality. Wealth, say some other words. Wealth, wealthy, prosperous, rich, something like that. Okay, opposite word is, you can say poor. Okay, formal, formalities, formal, informal, formal language, informal language. Now can you talk about neither nor? Neither nor, no, no, that is what? She is not, he is not, that is the sense we get here. Let us go to next page, shall we? Okay. Now just let me drag this photo down so that we can easily get one. I was one of the children. He was one of the children. Look at this one. One of the child, no. I am one of the teachers in the school. Okay. Do you understand? Somebody will say, I am one of the teacher. That is wrong one. I am one of the student. That's the wrong one. What is the right one? One of the children. One of those fruits are dirty. Okay. I was one of the children, a short boy. How was this APJ Abdul Kalam? Very short boy. Not very short actually. Short boy with a rather undistinguished looks. He's not such a handsome boy. Born to a tall and handsome parents. His parents were tall. His father was handsome. His mother was beautiful. But this boy has undistinguished looks. He is not so smart. He is smart, but looks are not that much. We lived in our ancestorial house. Look at this one. Ancestorial. Forefather's house. Old building, we can easily call. The house which is coming from generation to generation. Passing. Which was built in the middle of the 19th century. This house was built in the middle of the 19th century, maybe 1850, like that. It was a fairly large pakka house made of limestone and brick. Limestone, you know, so limestone means sunnapurai, we will say something like that, limestone and brick. Brick means, you know, the house is made of brick. On the Mosque Street in Rameshwaram, M-O-S-Q-U-E, Mosque is nothing but church, temple, mosque, street in Rameshwaram. My austere father used to avoid all inessential comforts and luxuries. My father was a rules Ramanujan. My father was a rules Ramanujan. So he wanted always to be with an orthodox rules and regulations. He to be away from all the comforts and luxuries. Just kana, kapada, gana, that's it. But not entertainment, but not enjoyments. All these things are not allowed in my family. Okay. My father used to avoid all inessential, essential, inessential. Essential means necessary. Essentials means necessaries, important things. There are important things are available, but not luxurious comforts. Luxuries means, you know, you can come from Hyderabad to Khammam by an ordinary bus as well as luxury bus. When you come by ordinary bus, you will just enjoy all the same comforts, but not seating facility. And what we can say, AC, all these things may not be provided, TV may not be provided, but you can just come in the same speed. However, all necessities were provided, all necessities, all the important things like what I told you are provided for in terms of food, in terms of medicine, in terms of clothing, all these things were provided. In fact, I would say mine was a very secure childhood. My childhood. So instead of my childhood, he said mine. This pen is mine. Instead of telling my pen, I say this is mine. I say this is my bike. Instead, I say this is mine. Mine in the sense, my pen, my book, my childhood. Do you understand? Can you follow me? Okay. Very secure life. Secure childhood. Both materially and emotionally. Materially means whenever he wanted to play something, there were things to play. Whenever he was crying, there was his father. Whenever there he wanted to laugh, there was his friends. Whenever he wanted to help his mates, there are his friends. So like that, his childhood was very pleasantry and happy life. Now let us see this picture so that you can easily understand how his childhood was going on. You just imagine where APJ Abdul Kalam is. Maybe this boy. Yes or no? You are right. Look at this boy. Here, there is a procession going on for the god. Yes or no? Yes. Some Sharmaji is just carrying the god. And here is some musician. He is playing. And there is one more small Shastri is playing. And here, there is a plate of some fruits and something puja samagri. And they are just going. Here you see all these flags are just here. They are walking on the road. Maybe you can easily understand they are in the procession to maybe temple or going to a riverside, something like that for bathing. You just look at this one. All these are going without chappals. You can easily understand this is a holy, holy ceremony, holy program. Or you can understand a sacred program. Okay. Now, let us go and see the next slide. Before going to next slide, just let me drag my photo down. The Second World War broke out in 1939. When I was 8 years old, for reasons I have never been able to understand, a sudden demand for tamarind seeds erupted in the market. Erupted. Eruption is nothing but straightly from 0 to 20, from 0 to 200, from 0 to 1000, like that, eruption. So never, what is opposite word of never? Ever. Okay. I have never been able to understand. I was not in a position to understand why there was a sudden demand. What is opposite word of sudden? Okay. Gradually, slowly. Okay. Sudden demand for tamarind seeds. Tamarind, you know, in Telugu we call Chintapandu. Okay. Tamarind seeds erupted in the market. I don't know why. The boy was only 8 years old at the time of 1939. It was a time of World War. What was the World War? Second World War. No reasons, I don't know. I used to collect the seeds and sell them to a provision shop on the street. What is that street? Ramayalayam Mask Street is there. In that street, he used to sell all his things. A day's collection would fetch me the princely sum of 1 anna. Oh, there was anna, 1 paisa, like that we call. 5 paisa, 2 paisa, 3 paisa. Did anyone see 5 paisa? Yes, I saw. 20 paisa, yes. Okay, my brother-in-law Jainul Abdin would tell me stories about the war. You would tell me some stories about the war, which I would later attempt to trace in the headlines in the what is that? Dinamani. This is a newspaper like Eenadu, Sakshi, like that. So this is also a newspaper in Tamil Nadu. Our area, being an isolated one, isolated means single. It is just located in some other area. That's why isolation. Isolation word you know already. Isolation is a well-known word after coming of this corona. Yes, was completely unaffected by the war. There is no war effect here. But soon, India was forced to join the Allied forces. You know, Allied forces and American forces. What are the other forces? Are Allied forces and Germany is one side, Japan is another side, and so. And something like a state of emergency was declared. Emergency was declared. You know, what are the emergency articles? 352, 360, 356. So, I don't want to explain you now all these emergency articles. The first casualty came in the form of suspension of the train halt at Rameshwaram station. So, this was a really great, a big blow. What was the big blow? The big blow was nothing but Rameshwaram, there came a Shaneshwaram. What is that Shaneshwaram? That Shaneshwaram is nothing but train halt is removed. I am sorry. Now all the passengers are cancelled due to this corona and COVID-19 effect. So like that, same thing happened in Rameshwaram. All trains are just removed their halt. They are not stopping in Rameshwaram. They are just leaving the Rameshwaram, telling hi, bye and going. The newspapers now had to be bundled and thrown out from the moving train on the Rameshwaram road between Rameshwaram and Dhanushkodi. Okay, that forced my cousin Shamsuddin, who distributed newspapers in Rameshwaram. So now you can understand who is the distributor of these newspapers. Distribution. Okay. Look at the different forms of the word. Distribute, distribution, distributed, distributor. Who is the distributor? My cousin. Who is his cousin? Shamsuddin. Okay. To look for a helping hand. Look at this one. Look for. Look for means search. Look for means wait. He was just looking for a helping hand. What is a helping hand? A hand which just helps. A person who helps. To catch the bundles and as if naturally I filled the slot. I was there. I was just an 8th class student. So I was there to fill the slot. Shamsuddin helped me earn my first wages. Half a century later, I can still feel the surge of pride in the earning of my own money for the first time. Okay, my dear students. So this is what happened. He just got some first amount of earning just through working as a paper boy. Okay, now we will see the next part in the next lesson. See you, my dear students. Bye. Thank you for attending my class. The remaining lesson we will see in the part 2 class. Bye.